KeyMe allows you to instantly make duplicate copies of your keys by storing a digital copy of them so you never get locked out again. And it'll open your rear. And the Marshall Dicycle is an electric motorcycle concept that doubles as amplifiers when instruments are plugged in. Vsauce, Kevin here. This is Mind Blow. The Café Latte printer allows customers to drink their own faces. Let's Café is a kiosk located in Taiwanese convenience stores that is offering customers the opportunity to print any picture taken from their phone instantly on top of their latte. It works by dusting the image with an edible powder using a computer-controlled printhead, and they've successfully used it as a novelty to increase business. The LiveMap helmet was created by Russian inventors to make a motorcycle helmet with built-in navigation. The helmet creates translucent, full-color images and text in the visor, giving the rider the ability to check speed, time, and get directions without taking their eyes off the road like traditional navigation. It's only slightly larger than a normal helmet and adjusts depending on the lighting outside, and they plan to sell them for around $2,000. Researchers at North Carolina State University have created a device that controls cockroaches using an Xbox Kinect. They created an interface that sends the roach on a predetermined track by using a computer to plot its course. Researchers wire sensors to the roach's external sensory organs, causing it to move forward. And small charges in the neural tissue tricks the roach into thinking its antennae are hitting a barrier, causing it to turn. Scientists in Japan cloned this mouse from only a drop of blood from the donor's tail. Tokyo Flash created the Kisai watch that lets users know whether or not they are intoxicated through the use of a built-in breathalyzer. By blowing into a hole located in the side of the watch for 5 seconds, the watch glows green if it detects no alcohol, yellow if alcohol is detected but you are in the legal limit, and red if you are legally drunk. The watch also has a built-in sobriety test that asks the user to stop a moving line at a certain point on the screen. SenSoria are a pair of socks that are able to track the way people walk. Developed by Heap Cylon by using a Bluetooth-enabled anklet in conjunction with the socks, the sensors in the socks transmit the data to a computer or a smartphone. SenSoria can determine improper walking or running habits, or if the foot is landing at an unsafe angle during particular activities. And they're initially targeting the device at runners. Wi-Fi is a prototype handheld device that researchers at MIT have created in order to see through walls. Users will be able to point the device at walls and see anything moving on the other side. Wi-Fi works by emitting Wi-Fi signals at the wall where some of those signals bounce off of the moving objects on the other side and back to the device. Wi-Fi could be used in multiple applications, including aiding police and rescue workers or creating better motion-controlled gaming systems. Archaeologists have recently discovered that flowers have been used at funerals for 13,000 years. This self-bearing robot was presented by the Carnegie Mellon University Robotics Institute in May of 2013. The plans to use self-bearing robots range from mining to military applications. This robot is able to travel to its location in one mode and then bury itself in another. Shown here digging through various things such as rice, sand, flour, and sugar, but it's still in the developmental stages and they're trying to make more efficient versions. This bike helmet is made from recycled paper pulp. It was created by students from the Royal College of Art in London by making a pulp out of old newspapers they mixed with an adhesive, pigment, and organic additive. They claim that they're rainproof for up to 6 hours and can be recycled again after being used to make more helmets. Though wearing these may be better than no protection, it's still unclear the actual safety of these helmets. The Termes project is developing self-organizing simple robots building 3D structures. Based upon the building abilities of termites, the robot is able to navigate, lift blocks, and build structures much larger than itself, and the researchers at Harvard University are looking into ways to further develop automated construction. Finally, Minsu Kim's Living Food Project is a concept involving food that moves on the plate and in your mouth by building on developments in synthetic biology. I'm gonna leave you with ping pong balls on fire. And as always, thanks for watching.